He will make up for our sinfulness. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of the heifer ashes can sanctify those who are defiled, so that their flesh will be cleansed, how much more will the blood of Christ? If for the Old Testament, the blood of the goats and the bulls was enough for them to sanctify them and cleanse them from their personal sin, how much more the blood of Christ cry aloud at the throne of his heavenly Father, 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 into your hands I commend my spirit. Because that's why he died, for one reason, to save us from sin. Who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God. Why unblemished? Because Jesus was born from a virgin. Jesus was born without sin. Jesus was like the lamb of the Paschal mystery, of the Passover that the Jewish people had to procure without no blemish, kill it, roast it, and eat it. And that lamb has to have no blemish on it. And the author continued to say that lamb is what we have now. Some people say, why there is no priest woman? Because, it's the scripture, even for a lamb of Easter, it didn't say any lamb has to be a male. And why? Because woman generates, but the man creates from outside of them. And that's why at the altar, the priest represents Jesus Christ as the Lamb of God. Because he himself is being slaughtered and offered himself to the eternal Father as a high priest. And then he continued to say, God cleansed our conscience from dead works to the worship of the living God. All of us before Christ died on the cross, we were living in the darkness of sin. And because Jesus now died, he himself is the one who by his death, now he restored us to the eternal Father, and we are now again able to worship him as living creatures. For this reason, he is the mediator of the new covenant. Jesus is the one that is between God and us. Since a death has taken place for deliverance from the transgression under the first covenant, remember that Jesus came purposely to destroy the power of sin and to deliver us from those sins of the old covenant. What was the sins of the old covenant? It's the sin of Adam and Eve. It's that sin when man wants to be like God. The sin of the angels. But that's why we know the fall of the angels. Because when God revealed to the angels that he is going to become human, the angels said, we will never serve someone who was less than us. Remember, there are five lives. Divine life, angelic life, human life, animal life, vegetarian life. And when the angels saw that they are going to adore somebody who is less than them, they say, non-serving, will not serve. That was the fall of the angels. And now, Satan in the garden is tempting the human nature, that nature that was created in the image of God, to go against the Creator. And here, man wants to be God. And that was the sin of the first covenant that God made with Adam and Eve. And that covenant was destroyed, because the second and everlasting covenant was restored. And that is the covenant of Jesus Christ. Those who are called may receive the promise of eternal inheritance. And those who are called to be part of this covenant, they will receive eternal life. Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Jesus Christ. How can we integrate that mystery into our lives? My dear people, as we know today, we celebrate a great event. When Jesus knows that he is going to the Father and he is going to leave the church alone. And he wants to remain with them in a very special way. And that's why he took bread and he took wine. And he changed them into his body and soul. Into his body and blood. And he committed them and said to them, whatever you do, whenever you do this, you remember me in loving you. Today, in a very special way, we recall how many fathers of the church have written about this sacrament. And per excellence, there is St. Thomas Aquinas, who the Tanto Mergo, the praises that we sing to God on this feast, even the liturgy of Corpus, is written by him. And we know that many of the fathers of the church has commented on this, because this was the center of the life of the Christians. In fact, even in the first beginning, the sacrifice of the Mass was celebrated in the home of Christians and not in the synagogues. What are we doing here? When we come together to celebrate the mystery of the body and blood of Christ, we are coming together to really give thanks to God, as we sang in that glory, to praise him, to adore him, to give him thanks. For what? For the great gift he gave us of his Son, Jesus Christ. That through the word and through the Eucharist, we are able to be equipped to continue in this journey towards our destination. Unfortunately today, many Catholics do not believe in the real presence. And those people are not far away from us, in fact, even from our community. Because the way we partake in the Eucharist, and the way we celebrate the Eucharist, there is no real commitment. Sometimes we do it because we are trained to do so, or is a habit, but we don't really understand that with Christ, we are called to be sons and daughters of one eternal Father. Few moments from now, you are going to say, our Father, not my Father, our Father. So by that word, we all become brothers and sisters with Jesus Christ. A few moments from now, the priest will say, this is my body. And at that very moment, the priest, he better mean it, what he say. Because he become body, broken, for the people he called to be served. At this time, I am called to serve the people of St. Anthony. And I have to be broken. Broken for those who are going through hard times. Be there for those who need you. To bring souls to Jesus. To make sure that you teach the truth of the church. That you discipline people from those states that are not really proper. To really instruct and teach to the catechism and the scriptures. To really be a shepherd, to watch over your flock from those who are really are attacking the integrity of the church. And that's why I say this is my body. Because like Christ, who my priesthood belongs to him, and I participate from his priesthood, because I am not priest at all, but I am taking from his priesthood, I have to understand that I need to be broken like he was broken on the water of Calvary. When I said, this is my body, which will be shed for you, yes, I have to shed tears over people who have left the faith. I have to shed tears with those who are going through hard time in life. I have to shed tears with those parents who bring their children to be baptized, to receive communion and confirmation, and they abandon the faith. To shed tears for those people who their faith is so artificial that when a problem arrives, they will give God out, throw out God out of the window. And that's why I have to be shed. I have to be sacrificed. And that's why the first reading speaks about blood.